Okay, I'm gonna run up to Jake. Shelby.
Hi.
Thank you.
trauma. Okay, okay. Hello, hello.
Good afternoon. My name is Fred Deanstead. I've been attending this rally in Michigan, Macomb County, for over 2 years. We come here every Sunday in support of freedom. We started out supporting the cause of a re-election of our President Trump. We believed that he was the right man for the office. We believed in his idea of a free and fair America to show the world what it's like. We understand that the president did not become our president for 2022. Now,
why you started this rally?
We started this rally so that we would have our president win his election campaign in 2020. Our cause was for freedom and for the beliefs of making America great again and America first. So when we started, our cause was for Trump and winning for freedom, but we started afterwards for showing that we were still there, that we weren't going to go away. We believed in the cause for freedom and the cause for America, and our fight was to show people that we haven't gone away, that we're still in this, and we're still going to support America's right. Our Macomb County, yes.
Adjust the volume, make it higher.
Thank you.
see.
Good afternoon. Hi, my name is Fred Deanstead. I'm from Macomb County, Michigan, and we're at our Freedom Rally here on a Sunday. We're here every Sunday for the past 2 years. We started out in support of President Trump's election, re-election, and our hopes did not become true. So we then continued our rally to keep the spirits up for those who really believed in the freedom in America's first policies. Our fight is in the Michigan. It's a battleground state, and for the past 2 years we've been preparing for another election in this midterm. Freedom is on the ballot. We have ballot proposals that take away freedom, and we have candidates who believe that the past election was unfair, and we have candidates who believe that the election was fair. So in Macomb County, we are battling to make sure that every vote, every legal vote, is counted. So Macomb County is the tip of the spear in the battle for freedom. We have support from parents. Parents who are very busy with raising their families, and they cannot support us, so seeing us on the street corners here supporting the freedom they believe in is energizing to them, and they can teach their children. This idea of freedom is not something that can be easily defined. You can show it, but it's hard to explain exactly what this is. But when mothers teach their children about the freedom, they make it clear and understanding, and people know that we are here to support America first. We're here to support free speech. We're here to support our Constitution. And we're here to support everybody's right to choose. To choose what the future is for their own families, not the future that the government provides or the government dictates. Political correct ideology is a determining factor in people's choices sometimes, and it's unfortunate because they don't actually consider the free choice, the real true free choice between those things that are good and those things that are bad. So I very much appreciate the attention that we are being given today in this interview. Thank you very much. God bless America. Leanne, or Kathy? That was okay.
So, not too close.
I mean, hold that. Are you gonna hold that?
Can I just get in there with her? I'm not gonna say anything.
I don't know what you want me to say. Whatever. Okay. Hi. We are here at 23 and Van Dyke with a loud car. We're basically fighting not just for our freedom, but for everybody's freedom. And we come out here, rain or shine, 12 to 3. We have been for at least the last couple of years. wonder if it's doing any good. And like I was saying, I was talking to my real estate guy, Bob, you know, not long ago, and he said, oh, are you still rallying on 23 and Van Dyke? And I'm like, yeah, why? And he said, I was thinking there was going to be something negative, like those stupid people, they're wasting their time. But he said, oh, he walked into a family reunion type thing, and they were all talking about us. And I'm like, well, what did they say? And they said, well, they said they admire us for being out there, if it's cold, if it's raining, whatever. We love that, the big trucks and the little kids, that's my favorite. And I said, well, what did they think, you know, inside? And he said, that we are giving them hope, that they're not the only ones. You know, we are the majority, but we've been the silent majority for so long, and the other side is very loud and obnoxious, so we need to be a little bit more loud and proud. And I guess when the people go by, if we're getting that kind of feedback, it's kind of helping. And, you know, we're all for immigration and everything, but the country is changing so much. I mean, you're afraid to send your kids to school because they're going to come back and you're not even going to know them, or they're never going to want to be in your family. We have a patriot here, Peter, who is one of the good guys also. Everybody here is good guys. And he came from another communist country like 20-something years ago, you know, because they fled to America because they wanted to be free. And he's enjoyed it for most of the time. Well, now, the last couple of years, he has been seeing what's going on. And he goes, the country is already into socialism, and people don't even know it. You know, they're like rigging elections, they're sending kids and indoctrinating our children. And, you know, it's like you feel almost helpless to stop it. Now, they came into the country legally. My husband actually came into the country many years ago legally, you know. And at that time, he had to have his brother was 20 years older, you know. He had to have some place to stay because he was only 15. They had to support him, send him to school, feed him, clothe him, etc. If you were older and you came to the country, you had to have someone sponsor you, you had to have a job ready so that when you came to the country, you would not be a burden on the country. You would be one of us, you know. And that's what we like. People come in, they want to be one of us. They want to be citizens. They want to work hard and get somewhere and make something of themselves. And it's all changing now. I mean, it's like they want to make everybody dependent on the government. And we don't want to do that. Like when they sent the unemployment checks, I had just left work, and I could have gone back and got all these unemployment checks, you know, for free. And I said, I don't want to do it. You know, I don't really need the money they had. And it's just one more person. I had a friend, they sent his mother an unemployment check, and she died 2 years before. You know, so, I mean, he was a good guy, and he sent it back, you know. But most people, you know, what do they figure it's another $600 or $1,200 of free money? You know, we have to get back into reality. I try to step back, and people, I know the mainstream media, and I hate to bring that up, but I think everybody's getting really tired of the MSM. Because that's all they do is lie to us, and it's like, don't believe your lying eyes. And some of my friends, I do have a couple friends who are on the other end of the spectrum, and I tell them, I said, you know, if you don't listen to me, don't listen to them, don't watch the TV. I said, just look around you. Are you better off now with this government the way it's doing us? Are you better now than you were 2 years ago? I mean, you go to the grocery store. I go to the grocery store. Half the things I had 6 things on my list last week that they didn't even have. They didn't even have them, you know. And I'm like, what's going on? Half the shelves are getting more and more empty. You know, prices are skyrocketing. You know, but they're not allowed to do any fracking anymore. I don't know. So 1, 2, 3, it's like no, and no, November. I mean, they're all bad. And with the abortion issue, I talked about that for 1 minute. Yeah, people think, and especially in Michigan too, a lot of people are not as involved. Not that I know this much and this much. But people think that if they vote no, that there's going to be no abortion that's allowed. And Michigan has, in their constitution, has an abortion. they could give him like sex change pills, you know, to like chemically castrate your son or your daughter. And they didn't even have to tell you. And they tell the kids, don't tell your parents. Don't tell your parents because they, your parents, won't understand. I mean, your parents, the one that you came from, the one that loved you, you know? Yeah. We have one time too. There's another one over here. Mark is like one of the best guys he's ever had. So, I don't want to take up too much time, but I'm happy that you're here. I think I saw Epoch Times at the Macomb rally in Warren. Yeah, I didn't see him at first, I saw the hat, and I'm like, you know, so. You know, we know that you're the good guys, too, and we're happy that somebody's out here and maybe somebody's seeing this. And if they want to come out here and join us, 12 to 3, every Sunday, rain or shine, if it's really pouring down, we'll have a problem. Okay, thank you. Cut out whatever sounded stupid.
mostly, and mostly about the election. Hello, my name is Mark Fortin. I'm chairman of the Macomb County Republican Party, and we've got a big election coming up here in a couple of weeks, and we're really working hard to get our candidates elected. We've got a lot of challenges. We feel that our elections are somewhat in danger, that the issues that happened in 2020, none of them have been fixed, so we have concerns there, but we're urging people to get out there and vote. One of the most important things, I don't care anywhere you are in America, is go out on election day and vote like it's supposed to be. They are using, one of the main weaknesses in our system is this huge push for absentee ballots. Don't send it in. Take your absentee ballot with you on election day to the polling place and vote. Take the absentee ballot with you, because many times people are told, oh, you voted already, and no, you didn't. You know you didn't. And if you got it in your hand, you can show them, okay? So go on election day, ladies and gentlemen, because that will put a big dent in a lot of the fraud that may happen. So we need to get our, and also these, in Michigan we have these three proposals. They must go down, especially number three. They claim that it protects the people since Roe v. Wade has been flipped, but it doesn't do that. It goes way, way beyond that. It attacks our children. It's all this gender-changing garbage and puberty blockers, all this kind of garbage, and abortion even after birth. This is really terrible. They're not telling you all that. They're just saying, oh, they're protecting your Roe v. Wade rights. No, they are not. They're opening up abortion with no limits, including what they're doing to our children and the schools and so on and so forth. It's much, much deeper than that. You must vote no on three. Number two is about our elections. It takes away all control of the elections and just opens it wide up to fraud without anybody investigating. In fact, it's even in there where you can be charged for complaining about the election. So ladies and gentlemen, you Michiganders, you got to get out there, vote on election day, vote no on all three proposals, and support these candidates. Really appreciate you. Thank you very much. God bless America.
Why are you here gathering every week?
Every week?
Yeah.
I wish I could tell you the exact number of weeks, but it's over 2 years, rain, shine, winter, spring, summer, fall. On this corner, these people rally. And it's really great, because what we're doing is staying in the minds of the voters. It's a very busy corner. We do rallies in other areas too, and other groups do rallies too in other areas. But anywhere there's a rally, people tend to forget. But they see you out here, and we know we still have the majority of support. People are honking and waving and for over 2 years, and it's really great. The people of Michigan see us out here. They remember what's going on. We're right at the corner of a gas station. They got the gas prices. They can see as they go by. We're energy independent. Trump proved we're energy independent. So these gas prices are pure politics. That's what it is. It's not supply and demand. It's politics. So people see us out here for over 2 years. We're going to keep on keeping on and reminding them. And they encourage us with their horn honking, their waving, and so on and so forth. So we encourage each other. That's a great big fear. You know, a lot of our people, we in Macomb County, we have a lot of groups. We have Ukrainians, we have Polish, we have Italians, all these different communities. And these people come, and there's a couple here today, a couple people here that lived under communism in Poland. And they tell us, you know, Americans have to wake up. I saw this, I lived it, I can see what's coming here. So we cannot lose the United States to socialism. We just can't have it. This globalism's got to stop. In Michigan, we have a unit party. The Republicans and Democrats are all one. We're going to create a two-party system in Michigan again, and we are going to pull America away from this downward slide to socialism. We must do it, and we're going to do it. What's very important on election day, all across America, not just Michigan, is go to your poll and vote in person. I know it might be difficult for some of us because we've been lulled into this easiness of just, oh, I can just get it in the mail and check, check, check. Well, that is one of the major avenues for voter fraud. When Americans voted on election day, for years and years and years, oh, there was little isolated things here and there, but our elections were solid. The American people should be going on election day and voting on election day. For instance, my own situation, this one, I have my son moved out of Michigan 28 years ago. Okay? Now, in the election of 2020, he was naturally not on the voter rolls for some time. But now, in 2022, all of a sudden, his name appears on the voter rolls. And I know he did not come in and sign up as a voter in Michigan. Also, at one of our meetings recently, a lady came up. Our meetings are great, over 300 people. This lady came up to me and showed me a voter card. And she showed me the card, and I said, "What's this?" She said, "They sent me a voter card for my mother, and she died in 2008. So the problems of 2020 are not only still there, but they're still working it. They're still developing it. They're still developing the fraud. The only way we can beat it is we have to overwhelm them." I hear people here and there, not so much anymore, but I've heard people say, "Oh, what's the sense of voting? They're going to steal my vote." No. Trump won in 2016 because everybody broke the algorithms. The Democrats knew that they owned that race. They knew, and that's why they went crazy when Trump won, because they thought that they had it in the bag, okay? And that's why they went crazy for 4 years. They're still going crazy. They're still investigating him, and they're determined it's not going to happen again. But we're going to make it happen again. But it's up to each and every one of you. We all have to go to the polls, and we have to vote. We don't pay attention, oh, this might be going on, or that might be going on. It doesn't matter. We got to do what we have to do for our children and grandchildren. Everything we're doing, we're talking about the next generation. The founders talked about the next generation. They talked about posterity all the time. Us, all we seem to care about is next week. We have to start thinking about our children and their future. And we have to start standing up, because once we turn into a full-blown socialist state, which is very close right now, there won't be no peaceful coming back. But right now, we got to do what we have to do. It's up to you, for your children and grandchildren. On election day, go vote. Don't send in that ballot. Take it with you and go on election day and vote. Thank you very much. God bless all of you.
no in November. Oh no, I want to MD.
Thank you.
November on proposals 1, 2, and 3. They're not what you think. Read those proposals. Know what you're voting on. Vote no on November on all 3 proposals.
Proposals on the ballot in Michigan. All 3 of them change the Constitution in Michigan, which makes them extremely important. Proposal 3 is about abortion. As you know, Roe v. Wade has been turned over by the Supreme Court, which brings the issues then to the purview of the states. Now, they've started this thing, and if it's approved by the voters, it does not. They're marketing as abortion rights. They're marketing as a way to guarantee women the right to abortion, like Roe v. Wade did. It's supposed to fix, I guess you should say, what the Supreme Court has done. That's how they're advertising it. But it is not that. It's much, much more. It's abortion up until birth. If a child survives abortion, you can kill it. It also takes away parental rights. It's got involved all this transgender stuff, this puberty blocker things, making it legal what the schools are doing, which may make parents criminal for all we know. We have no idea how this will be interpreted by the courts. And we feel our courts have become a mini legislature and not really a check and balance like the founders envisioned. The courts are supposed to be a check and balance. This thing is so unconstitutional on its face, it never should have been allowed on a ballot. But the Supreme Court of Michigan allowed it. So now it's up to the people of this state to say, no, we don't want to expand abortion way beyond Roe v. Wade. No, we don't want to push transgender stuff on our children at the schools. We don't need all this stuff. So people must vote no, and again, please, 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 go on election day and vote at the polls. That's the way America always was. We have to try to get back to election day, and so that our elections are much more secure. Thank you very much. Vote no on all 3, but especially 3 is very dangerous and murderous. Thank you.
What is Proposal 2?
Proposal 2 is very bad also. It completely opens up our elections. Like many of us are demanding voter ID, things like that. This gets rid of all limitations whatsoever. It really liberalizes to the extreme our voting process, which is going to make it very easy to commit fraud, very easy to mislead people, commit fraud, so on and so forth. It may even, the way it's worded, it may even make it a misdemeanor or a chargeable offense if you question the elections. That's how bad this is. And it's going to wind up being our Constitution. The Constitution of America and a state should not be that easily changed. There should be a stronger process for that. Because what we've done, especially in Michigan, we have such an inactive legislature, and the Republican side of the aisle is so inept that the people are looking for other ways to get things passed. So they've opened up this whole petition process much more than it was ever designed to be, because our ineffective legislature just sits there. And we're going to keep pushing and pushing to make the Republican Party in Michigan Republican again, so that the voters in Michigan can be proud to vote Republican again, and they're not just voting the lesser of two evils all the time. We want people we can vote for. We want real Republicans running for office. Right now, we have to work to keep the majority, because committee seats are so important and the majority gets them, right? We have to keep that majority. But as we go forward here, we're going to work on trying to get more and more real Republicans elected in Lansing.
What is proposal?
I'm sorry.
What is proposal one?
Proposal one expands the term limits. I believe it doubles them. I haven't read that much into it, to be honest, because the other two are so terrible. But most people do not like the idea of giving these people longer terms. We have to find ways to make our elections more even for challengers, the way it is right now, incumbents rule, so to speak. So the only defense we have is term limits. And a lot of people want them term limits to stay the way they are and not expand it.
What is the value of Republican Party poll? Would you please introduce to our audience the value?
The value of the Republican Party?
Yes.
Well, the Republican Party in Michigan, we say, is a unit party. We've been working very hard to get them to be more active in doing things against this governor. This governor has run rampant in Michigan. She's killed people in old folks' homes. She's destroyed lives, small businesses left and right, especially restaurants. People, their whole livelihood have been destroyed, and yet, in her socialist mindset, the big companies, the chains, they're doing just fine. She didn't shut them down. So, in the meantime, while all this is going on, and they're shutting down our schools and all this stuff, our Republicans weren't squawking at all. They weren't carrying on at all. It's just incredible that they give us the excuse that, oh, well, we may have the House and Senate, but she can veto things. Well, that doesn't mean you don't pass things. You pass good legislation, you make her veto them for 2 years, and then you go after her for that if you can show it's good legislation. They had total gloves off with this woman. She does what she wants in Michigan, and Michigan's been damaged, and there's nothing in there to prevent it from happening again. A governor has no right to shut down businesses. It's unconstitutional. And our legislature, our Senate and House have done nothing to fight her in the last, especially 2 years. And it's really sickening. But we're going to, like I said, we're going to rebuild the Republican Party in Michigan. We're going to make it Republican again so that they are an adversarial party to the Democrats and not a bunch of, they got a word for it, their colleagues. They like to call each other colleagues. They get together and run our lives. Lansing is run by dirty money, dark money, PACs, and is run by lobbyists. You can hardly get a bill passed, you can hardly get anything done if it's not blessed by the Speaker or the Senate Majority Leader. So why do we have these elections to pay all these people? All we have to do is have a governor, a House member, and a senator. Let them free rule, right? Because that's what's going on now. They just do what they dang well want. The legislate, the people that we elect, the last thing on their mind is representing the people. We live in a republic, ladies and gentlemen, not a democracy. We elect people to go to Lansing or Washington or your state capital. They're supposed to represent their constituents, not the PACs, the dark money, the lobbyists. This stuff's got to come to a stop. We have to rebuild the republic because we're losing it. We're losing down that slippery slope, and it's getting faster and faster, and we got to put on the brakes. Everybody, you guys can all make a difference. We got a war going on in Michigan.
Hope no one remembers. go, Brandon!
Right to me, so am I holding this or are you gonna? Judge Michael Warren of the Oakland County, Michigan Circuit Court, and I'm running for the Court of Appeals for the state of Michigan. I've been on the Oakland County Circuit Court for over 20 years. I've tried over, almost 20 years, I've tried over 360 jury trials. I've been recognized as Judge of the Year, Judge of the Decade, and I'm actually in the Hall of Fame of the International Association of Top Professionals, and I'm looking forward to bringing that experience to the Michigan Court of Appeals, where about 98% of appeals are resolved. Finalized at that level. I'm in Oakland County Circuit Court, and the district that I'm running in includes Genesee, Oakland, and Macomb counties. I've been a proven rule of law judge. I have a reputation of being someone that is by the book, fair and impartial, and dedicated to the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence, and I'm looking forward to bringing that to the Court of Appeals. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they're endowed by their creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and that to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. That when any form of government becomes obstructive to these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or abolish it and to establish new government, laying as foundation such principles, and organizing power in such forms that which seem most likely to affect the safety and happiness. Those words from the Declaration of Independence were revolutionary in 1776, and they remain revolutionary today. It is the sacred obligation of judges to affirm those principles of the Declaration of Independence, and that are now embedded in our Constitution, to protect those principles in our Constitution, and to make sure that judges are fair and impartial arbiters of what the law is, and not to legislate from the bench. And that's my mission and goal, and I'm looking forward to winning in the November election in Michigan.
Would you please explain the position you are running for?
Yes, so in Michigan we have a trial court level, which is the circuit court and the district court. So my circuit court is Oakland County. We have about 1.2 million people in it. And then if you're unhappy with what happens at the trial court level, then you can appeal, and you have basically a right to appeal to the Court of Appeals. And that's a statewide court. There are 25 judges in the statewide court. They sit in three judge panels. And they basically make the decisions, as I said before, for about 98% of the appeals are resolved at the Court of Appeals. So it's very important. It involves every kind of case you can think of, criminal cases, family law cases, probate, the scope of government, civil rights, elections, your unalienable rights to free speech and religion. All those kinds of cases go to the Court of Appeals, so it's extraordinarily important. But most people don't think about it. It's not a high visibility race, so I've done everything in my power to raise up the profile of this race so that I can win in November.
So, what do you think that is important for Republicans, for you, to have this position?
So, it is a nonpartisan position, so I'm speaking to everybody, but I know Republicans are particularly concerned about ensuring that there's a vibrant separation of powers. So we have a legislative branch that passes the law, we have an executive branch that's to enforce the law, and then we have a judiciary, which is to determine the law as it's been provided by the lawmaker, either the people through the Constitution or the legislature through statutory provisions, and to apply that law in particular cases. It is not the role of the judge to legislate and to impose their policy on the people of the state. It is their role to just interpret the laws that's been given to them. So we shouldn't be adding things to the law that don't exist, and we shouldn't be taking things out of the law that aren't there. So if you want a proven rule of law judge who has 20 years of experience ensuring the integrity of the Constitution and the law, as opposed to legislating from the bench and being judicially active, then you'd want to vote for Judge Michael Warren. And you can learn more about me at judgemichaelwarren.com. Also, I'm the co-founder of what's called Patriot Week. And this is a national initiative. My then 10-year-old daughter pounded the table and demanded a new celebration for America. And we celebrate our founding first principles of the Declaration of Independence, key documents and speeches that embody those, founding fathers and other great patriots, and flags from our history. And it's nonpartisan. But for those of you that really care about the integrity of the Constitution, civics history, understanding the great blessings that we have in America, that's what Patriot Week's all about, to renew the spirit of America. We have lesson plans, a podcast, a TV show, a video series, and it goes, and you can check that out at patriotweek.org. That's patriotweek.org. And we also have during the week, which is from 9/11 to 9/17, the 17th is the signing. The anniversary of the signing of the Constitution. We've had parades, paloozas, picnics, festivals, all kinds of fun activities, panel discussions, guest speakers, not just in Michigan but across the country. And we're really looking forward to having another fabulous Patriot Week next year. We had a great one this year, the 13th year. We were unanimously recognized by the U.S. Senate through a bipartisan resolution from Senator Kennedy down south and Gary Peters in Michigan. One's a Republican, one's a Democrat, but they came united. We had a unanimous resolution from the Senate for 4 years in a row. We've had also more than 15 states recognize Patriot Week, so it's a growing initiative, and I'd encourage people to go to judgemichaelwarren.com or patriotweek.org to learn more about both my campaign, but also Patriot Week as well.
Good?
Thank you.
All right, make sure you send me those photos.
Yes, I will. Good.
Thank you.
Come on.